thank you for your kindness. Everybody, thank you, Bishop Stoops, for inviting us back, and it doesn't get any better than watching two of your grandchildren be filled with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. It's as good as it gets. Amen.
Yeah. God, wonderful Lord and Savior that we serve and worship tonight. Amen. Almost failed to do this, and my apologies, but to the main district, we certainly would not want to let camp meeting slip by without the opportunity to thank our district superintendent and his wife for the leadership that they give for the main district. Thank you, brother and sister Stewart. I think it is fitting that we give them a very hearty round of applause and thanks. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. We love these folks very much. Been a part of the main district for many years now, served in various capacities in this district, and we are very appreciative of them. Amen. Praise God. Thank you for the students. We appreciate it.
I just realized what was going on. I saw somebody waving a cell phone. I thought they were waving at me, so I thought, man, there must be a message. And then I saw Sister Channel standing over there on the porch, and it still didn't dawn on me what they were doing. Thank you very much. Hey, this has got to be one of the best camps we've ever had, don't you think? And tonight, I believe that God has a word for us. Let's not get in a hurry.
Amen.
Leave camp. Start thinking about tomorrow. All of us have things to do, but let's forget about mañana. And let's just allow the Lord to do what He wants to do in our hearts. There's somebody that can receive the Holy Ghost tonight. There's somebody that can be healed tonight and delivered. And everybody can be renewed. Praise God. Brother and Sister Dillon, we are so thankful truly to have you here in the main district, and I think you can tell I'm pretty transparent. If I like you, it shows.
Yes.
If I don't like you, it probably shows. But I really like these people, and I love them, and we're very happy to have them. Brother Dillon is doing a tremendous work in Madison, Mississippi. I got to go down and be with him just for a day last August, I believe it was, and I was just so impressed by what the Lord is doing through them and the great ministry there. And then all the home missionaries from North America, I think it cost over $400,000, if I remember right, for them to give all the home missionaries and their families a place to come, transportation, food to eat, a place to sleep, and some powerful spiritual renewals. The Word of God taught and preached, and I believe that every one of them left with a renewed fervor and strength and anointing for the job that God has called them to do. Matter of fact, there's probably some home missionaries, no doubt, some home missionaries from our district that's benefited from the Apostolic Conference in Madison. So thank you, Brother and Sister Dillon, for your love and burden for the Lord's work. And thank you for giving yourself so sacrificially to the cause of God. God bless you.
Amen. Put your hands together. Let's celebrate the goodness of God. And all that the Lord is doing and going to do. I said He's going to do. I said He's going to do. Some 19 years we've been doing this, and it's just reached a place that, amen, it doesn't let you sleep much at night when you stop and think of the budget and 150 hotel rooms rented, and you got one you're paying for. Amen. And do that Tuesday through Friday and feed over 500. But most of all, I want you to pray for 160.
160 home missionary children that are coming. 160 children that God will fill them with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. I want you to pray for those babies, because can you imagine what that will do to mom and daddy? Because a lot of the kids are already doing Sunday school work. They're working in the church. They just need the Holy Ghost. Praise God. It's going to be a happening in Madison the first week in August, and you're invited to come 2nd, 3rd, and 4th, amen, of August. It's going to be a powerful event, and if you've never been there, you need to come before you die, praise God. Because God's economy is just like our economy, supply and demand. Reason there's not much supply, there's not much demand. But I'm telling you, when you get hungry people, amen, it's easy to feed hungry people. People that's full. Right. Amen. Full people complain about what side the fork's on, the spoon's on. But honey, hungry people just want to know where the rice and gravy is at. Amen. They just want to know, hey, come on somebody. How many knows what I'm talking about right now? Hallelujah. Well, come on, clap your hand to the Lord and give God some praise and thank Him. What a privilege it has been to be with you here in the main district this week. And I tell you, it's just passed too quick. I'm just, amen. I am so excited about what God is going to do in this place. And I am here today to challenge you. Praise God. Amen. I tell you what, this Chop Chop Chicken here, amen, I'm just going to give, where's those pretty two little girls that got the Holy Ghost? I'm fixing to give you, amen, your first church's chicken. Praise God. Hallelujah. Recognizes we're facing the end of our days also. And the Apostle Paul gave us an ingredient that we must activate in our own life. 2 Timothy chapter 4. Again, reading at verse number 6. Very familiar reading if they're already in the Word of God. But I want you to notice what he is trying to convey. I feel this. If I've ever felt in my soul anything, I feel this is what's got to happen to every apostolic that I preach to tonight. To every individual that will hear the Word of God, this has to be applied in your life. The apostles.